Hello, I'm here today to show you some fun new products from this 2010-2011 Stampin' Up! Idea Book and Catalog. So, set this aside and I'll show you the different things that I used to make this card. First of all, I used a set called Artistic Etchings and the Level 3 Hostess set called Occasional Quotes. And since these are clear mount stamps, I had to mount them onto an acrylic block. And a quick and easy way that I do that is I set my stamp down, my stamp image down, and then I just press down onto it and pick it up, and I find that works really well. Okay, to start with my background, I cut out a piece of the newsprint designer paper series, and it's a fun designer series, double-sided, with a lot of options and a lot of different things that you can do with it. So the first thing I need to do is I'm going to adhere this with my snail adhesive to my black cardstock mat. This is just a basic black. So line that up and burnish that down. Now for my ribbon piece, I often do it in two pieces, and this saves a little bit of ribbon. So I'm going to take my longer piece and a mini glue dot and put one on one end, press down onto the roll of mini glue dots and pick it up so that I have my adhesive on the back. Place this about where I want it on the front of the card, and then just fold over the back two little sides to adhere that down. Next step is just to take my other piece of ribbon and tie a quick knot around the piece that is glued down. And pull that nice and tight. And then I can take some scissors and trim the tails so that they look how I want them to look. Okay, now I can just adhere this to the base of the card. And I'm just using a very vanilla card base. So put that down just like that. There we go. Now I can work on my focal piece. Okay, I'm using a little bit larger block than the Eiffel Tower because I find I have a bit more control with that. So going down into the basic black ink and stamping down my tower. And then I'm going to stamp the word more off to the side there. Then this next step, I want the flourish in red, but I don't want it quite as dark as the cherry cobbler is. Ink is straight. So I'll stamp it off twice, and then I will stamp it down, and it'll be a little bit lighter, so my black is more prominent. Then the last step from the greetings is to take the thank you sentiment, and I'll stamp that down and up. And then to finish it off, I'm going to put some of the dimensionals, one on each corner, just like this, and then we'll peel that off. I like the dimensionals because they will give a little bit of height and let it sit nice and straight over that ribbon. Oops. Last one here. And then just mount this to the card front under the rib, under the little edge of ribbon. And there you have a quick and fast card using new product from the 2010-2011 Stampin' Up! Idea Book and Catalog. Thanks for watching.